Hello, I'm Mitchell from SheetGo, and today I'm going to teach you how to use the true formula in Google Sheets. So the true formula is a standalone formula, doesn't have any kind of practical usage. So first I will show you the formula, and afterwards I will show you the statements that might appear in, for example, the OR and the AND formula, and many others. So let's use the true formula. And in the true formula, I may not put in any kind of argument, so let's use an argument to see what happens. So is equal to 848, g2 is equal to 848. Then my statement will turn into an NA, as with the true formula you may not put in any kind of argument. So when I'm deleting the information and my statements, then it will turn into true. Well, in my opinion, this is quite useless. So we will use a statement instead. So I say that G2 is equal to 848, which is of course true. Then my statement will turn into true. And with the true statement, I can do a couple of things. So I will use the if formula to change my true into a meaningful context. Well, we already made a video with regards to the if formula, so if you want to read more, please click on the link down below in the description, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. So let's go through it very briefly. So if k2 is equal to true, and with the true you do not need any kind of accents, which is one of the only exceptions. So you shouldn't use accents when putting true or false into an equation. So when it's true, then I want it to be, now I'm using the accents, right. And if it isn't true, then I want it to be wrong. So let's say wrong. And again, the double accents. So close brackets. And as you can see, my true has changed into right. So this is how I use the true formula together with the if formula. I want to thank you for your time. And if you liked the video, please put a thumbs up. Goodbye.